I have male baldness, 3 vertex type. I've been using minoxidil 10% last 6 months. No result. Is transplant the only cure?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a photo and a description of your male pattern hair loss of the vertex type, and you want to know, is hair transplant your only option? Well, I'm happy to report to you that it's not your only option. A little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon. I've been practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I've specialized in hair restoration surgery for many years, but in the past several years, we've actually developed an alternative treatment called hair regeneration, which has turned out to be quite an effective way to treat hair loss, in particularly people who still have existing hair. You know, if someone is bald and they want hair in place where they don't have hair, hair transplant is really still the only option. But in someone like yourself, where you are thinning, hair regeneration, which is our concept that we developed combining a material called acellular matrix, originally designed for wound healing, combine that with platelet-rich plasma, and using a specific method that we've developed over by treating hundreds of patients from around the world for so many years, we have a certain protocol that has turned out to be close to 100% effective for male pattern hair loss. What we do is essentially an injection. It's a treatment that takes less than 2 hours to perform, and we follow our patients very closely, and our data supports the efficacy of this treatment. Basically, what we've learned is the earlier we catch somebody, the better off they are, because the more hair that we can save, the more volume we can get back. But even people who are more of like a Norwood 3 to 4 have had a lot of regrowth, and we've been very impressed with the results. And now we've actually scaled and developed a company called Trichostem Hair Regeneration, where we're trying, our mission is to bring this treatment closer to many people, because as we're honored and privileged to get patients who come to us from all over the world for this treatment, but we want to be able to make it more accessible. There is a method, there's a technique, there's formulations, and we want to ensure a certain level of quality. But you can see that the results are quite impressive and are, in most cases, depending on the level of hair loss, we've actually been able to demonstrate that the injection without surgery can exceed the results of 2 hair transplant surgeries. So interestingly, it's a fraction of the cost, a fraction of the downtime, and the results can be quite impressive. And it avoids the downward spiral, if you will, of a patient who is particularly in the younger, in their like the early 20s, and from the 20s to 30s, who have an onset of hair loss, who, if they were to do transplants, will eventually run out of donor area and may not have enough coverage. With this injection, we're able to restore a lot of volume. We have 5 years of data which show longevity. If they're in discussion about this and in relationship to hair physiology, it's conceivable that someone may need to do this injection every 3 to 5 years. But in the big picture of choice, getting an injection every 3 to 5 years to keep your hair thick, nice and thick, is a heck of a lot easier and more desirable than getting a transplant every few years until you run out of donor area. So I think we've been able to answer that question, is that hair transplant is not your only option. Hair regeneration is something that you should certainly investigate. More than ever, we are very enthusiastic about helping people with hair loss, and it's made a big difference for the patients who come to us. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.